say. David won't stop writing songs. I never wanna shake their hands and stay. I never wanna shake their hands and stay.
Guys, Sunday the 31st of March 2019. Welcome to my channel, Jay Hikes North. Welcome to the West Highland Way. Right, guys, for anyone that's subscribed to my channel, this is a part of the path that intersects with the John Muir Way. This is one of the recent sections of the John Muir Way that I did prior to doing this walk. We should have the red house coming up that's got West Highland Way written over the gate. A lot of people will know that as a good point of reference. Is it just me that wants to live in that house? Alright guys, so we're 6.5 kilometres into the walk now, and this is a notorious spot on the West Highland Way. So you come off this country path here and we need to walk along this B road here, and then there's a gate on the right hand side where we'll finally get off this road. So we walk along this B road for about 200 metres and at this point we cross the road. Alright guys, so we've just stopped for a quick breather here. I just thought it would be a good time to go through my itinerary for the West Highland Way. So we're doing this over 6 days. I've done this before, I've wild camped, I don't fancy it again. So day one will be Milngavie to Drymen. Day two will be Drymen to Rowardennan. Day three, Rowardennan to Inverarnon. Day four, Inverarnon to Bridge of Orkney. Day five, Bridge of Orkney to Kinlochleven, and then Kinlochleven to Fort William on day six. Accommodation, I'll be staying at the Drymen Inn tonight. Tomorrow it'll be Rowardennan Youth Hostel, and then it'll be Benglass campsite. And then it'll be the Bridge of Orkney Hotel, and then it'll be the Tail Race Inn in Kinlochleven, and on the Friday evening I will be getting the Caledonia Sleeper back down to Glasgow. Alright guys, so we're 2 hours and 10 minutes into the walk, 9.3 kilometres, that is the Glengoyne Distillery, just straight ahead there,
and I know you can't see for those trees, but the Beech Tree Inn is just past that, so I don't know, maybe we've got about 40-50 minutes before we get there, and that'll be our first stop. Alright guys, so we're 2 hours and 40 minutes into the walk. That's us just approaching the Beech Tree Inn. So time to get a wee something to eat. Go through my photos, my videos, and then we'll just go non-stop into Drymen. A bit of luck, I'll get into Drymen for about 8 o'clock-ish. So here's hoping. Some people probably can't read that, but here we go. You've walked about 7 miles. Come see our smiles and have a cup of tea, or try out our platter. It doesn't matter. There's a warm welcome at the Beech Tree. Burgers and chips, starters and dips, or even a sensuous pud. Great value for money. Sit out if it's sunny. Just come and enjoy your food. If the rain start to piss, gie the garden a miss, or maybe try out our shelter. In or out, you can wear muddy boots. The welcome you'll get is a belter. Take the weight off your feet, have something to eat, or even visit our loo. Kids can feed the ducks or play in the park. There's plenty for them to do. When you're fully replete, I don't know what that means. When you're fully replete and you've had a seat, thinking about your next night on the tiles, keep that smile on your face. Fort Bill is the place. It's only another 87 mile. Alright guys, so 3 hours and 10 minutes into the walk, and I've been waiting to approach this gate. One of the guys that I'm subscribed to on YouTube, a guy called Hounds of Howgate, done the West Highland Way, and look at this gate. What's that rock? How cool is that, eh? Talk about cheap thrills. Right guys, so 3.5 hours into the walk, we're just crossing the road here. It's worth pointing out though that upon leaving the Beech Tree Inn and getting to this point here, there's hardly any way markers. So if you're, you know, slightly confused, you just follow the path straight, and just keep following the John Muir Way signs, and you'll be cool. Alright guys, so 4 hours and 17 minutes into this walk, we've just walked up this, it's kind of a very slow ascent, just hitting the 19 kilometre mark for now, not far to Drymen. It's like they knew that someone would want to use that after walking up that hill, eh? Right, not long to go now. I'll do my next video once I get to the B&B, get checked in, and I'll do my next video in my room once I get a shower and stuff. See you in a bit. Alright guys, so just hitting the 4.5 hour mark, 20 kilometres, and this is a very good point of reference that you'll see in a lot of YouTube videos, where you're walking through this field. Usually there's cattle in here.